Did you know that men can get breast cancer? This year in the US, it's estimated that 2,670 men will be diagnosed and close to 500 will die from the disease. Men are at a much lower risk, but breast cancer does not discriminate. Michael shares his story.
Yes, men get breast cancer. In 2007, I was first diagnosed with breast cancer. In September of 2015, we found out that the cancer not only came back again, but that it had spread and that I was now metastatic.
They did notice some growth in the cancer in my lungs and in one of the lymph nodes in my chest. You know, even though I'm feeling great, there's always that tinge of anxiety. The key is allowing yourself to be afraid.
These 10 years have been quite a change.
Right now at this moment, I'm okay.
Michael is here today along with our good friend and colleague, Dr. Frieda Lewis Hall, Chief Patient Officer of Pfizer. And Michael, what initially, if I may ask, gave you cause for concern?
In 2007, I had noticed a lump next to my left nipple and was told then that it was breast cancer. And also found out that I was the carrier of the BRCA2 gene.
Men with the BRCA2 gene who have been identified as having an inherited mutation in the BRCA2 gene have about a 6% chance of developing breast cancer over the course of their lifetime. Now, this is much higher than men without an inherited gene mutation, which is less than 1%.
And doc, what are some of the other risk factors associated with this disease?
So, family history matters. The risk of breast cancer increases if you have a blood relative who's had it. Age matters. And although breast cancer can strike men at any age, it usually happens between 60 and 70. There are also some other risk factors: obesity, certain testicular conditions, liver disease, and heavy drinking.
And here's a question we get asked about this disease. How do men get breast cancer when they don't have breasts?
Let's set the record straight. So everyone is, male and female, are born with breast tissue and milk ducts. Now, in females, hormones stimulate the development of full breasts, and in men, they stay small and flat. But the important thing to note here is that men do have breast tissue, which means they can get breast cancer.
Infiltrating ductal carcinoma, or IDC, is the most common type of breast cancer when it comes to men. IDC does start in a milk duct and grows into the fatty tissue of the breast, but because the male breast is much smaller, most male breast cancers start relatively close to the nipple. Michael mentioned his warning sign was a lump near his nipple. Dr. Frieda, can we talk about some other symptoms to look out for?
So absolutely, you wanna watch out for thickening of the breast tissue and also changes in the skin that covers the breast. That would include dimpling, puckering, redness, and scaliness. And also, if there is a discharge from the nipple, that is a warning sign that you should call your doctor right away. And then, Michael, you mentioned another common symptom.
Yeah, I noticed that my left nipple had inverted, which means turning inward.
And, Michael, unfortunately, your breast cancer came back and spread to other areas of your body. Breast cancer can metastasize and also spread to lymph nodes under the arm or the collarbone and cause a lump or swelling there even before the original tumor is large enough to be felt, which brings us to another important fact about breast cancer. Men have a higher mortality rate than women do.
So this could be due to a lack of awareness and screening. If a man doesn't think that a lump is breast cancer, then he may be diagnosed at a later stage. One thing that I should mention is that for men who are identified 35 years and older that have a BRCA mutation, they should be screened at their yearly exam for breast cancer, and they should learn how to do breast self-exams.
Michael, you're a male with male breast cancer. Is there a stigma associated with it in your mind?
I do believe that there is, because still so many people typically think that this disease only happens to women.
And you've been through so much. Has there been something that's helped you along the way?
I am so grateful for the fact that I have wonderful friends and family who support me every day. I also have my partner, Tim, who is not afraid of the fact that I'm living with stage 4 metastatic breast cancer. I also work with MetaViver, which is an organization that raises awareness of stage 4 metastatic breast cancer and also works to increase funding for research solely focused on metastatic breast cancer.
Well, thank you, Michael, for being here, for sharing your story, for persevering. And incidentally, Matthew Knowles, the father of singer-actress Beyoncé Knowles-Carter, just recently revealed his own breast cancer diagnosis. Dr. Frieda, in light of this, where can people get more information?
Yep, so a great place to start is gethealthystayhealthy.com. And of course, while you're there, you can sign up for our monthly newsletter.
Thank you, Dr. Frieda.
Thank you, and thank you.
Michael, thank you, and best of luck to you, Michael, going forward. Stay tuned, we'll be right back.